Now let's quickly look at the basic data we need to project population, because we always project population. You need it to be able to carry out with your planning and come up with some policies. So we're going to quickly walk through it. I will take you through this table that is here. Let's watch out and see what we're going to have here. Now you have four columns here. First column, the serial number, data required, purpose, and source. Now, if you look at the population projection, the first one is said base population by age and sex, because you always need the base population. You need to know the beginning population. Now, here, why the purpose, the beginning population for the projection. Source, the census. You need all this. I might not take you through deeply into it because you have it to read. Now, you need the time series of life expectancy by birth and by sex, because you need the life expectancy. This will form the basis for the projection of mortality trend. Again, here you could find it from National Life Table or estimate by the third parties. Then the third one you will need is the time series total fertility rate and fertility rate by age of mothers, because you're going to work on fertility rate. If you have women that are still giving birth to children having high fertility rate, it means your population will be large. And again, it has to do with age, the age group. You can decide to look at the women that are from age 15, maybe to 24. No, the fertility rate might be higher than those that are from 25 or from 30 and above. So these are very, very vital for you to project, you know, in the future, because you want to plan for the future. Now, the next one is a time series on net migration, total net amount, and or by the age and sex. So looking through what we have here, this is the work that I called from CAR Hub, the World Bank, because it is very vital. You look at the base population by age and sex, look at the life expectancy, look at the fertility stage, and look at the total migration. Now let's quickly see this, what happened here. If you have to look at the base data required for projection, here we have brought them out. It has been summarized here. You have what you have here is what I brought it here now. So all you need to do, remember, if you have to prepare for projection, first, you must have the base population. What is the current population? Put it by sex, put it by age. Again, you must know the life expectancy age. There are some persons, they have put their life, some countries, their life expectancy is 60, some 55. I think in Nigeria, it's between 55 and 60. At the rate at which, from here, you have a lot of persons dying from that particular age. So the life expectancy is quite important. Then again, you need to know the fertility rate, and finally the migration. So once you have this, you'll be able to do a good projection. Now this is an example. Let's look at this population projection of female cohorts. This is a female cohort and want to project. Right here we have been given the year of birth. This is from between 60 to 64 to 85 and 90. Their population, this were their population as stated here as at 2013, and their population as at 2017. And these are the projective fertility rates. These are women. And you discover that they belong to different age group. This is their age group here, and they have different fertility rates. Now let's see, we're asked to consider those between that were born from 1960 to 1964. Because what happened for those that are between 1960 to 1990 may not be the same for others, but we are considering only these cohorts. This is a cohort because they belong to one group. Cohort means a group. So in this case, we have to look at the average of the population in 1960 to 1964. You know, in 1960, you have 61, 62, 63, 64. Now the average here is what? If you look at the what you have here in 2013, you have 700,000. Then in 2017, there were 680,000 over 2. That will give you 690. This is the average for those people that were born between 1960 to 1964. Whether you were born 1961, 62, 63, or 64, this is what you have. Now, if you continue again, the total number of births expected from this group, female cohort, between 2013 and 2016 is what? Because that is what we are trying to find out. What will be the total number of births that will be expected? Right here, to get the total number of births, we have no the fertility rate. We have the average, so we multiply, divide it, sorry, by 1,000. Remember, I told you when you are working on demography, you always use 1,000. It's a formula. You base it on it so that you'll be able to get what you need. Now you have 690,000 times 800. Remember, the 800 has been given to us as fertility rate. If you are in, you want to do the practical sense of it, you could go to the ministry and obtain it, or you calculate it yourself. So when you do that, it means we are expecting 552,000. It means this can be put into male and female further. Because this 552,000, you can decide to put it to know how many males, how many females. You go further to inquire. Because all these are important when you are planning for education. Now, the usefulness to educational planning, get the survival rates for specific age group, e.g. 0 to 4 group. Let's assume that the survival rate for 0 to 4 group is 80%. What are we saying here? Let's assume for children that have been given birth to between 0 to 4 years, this means 80% of them normally survive. That's what we are saying here. We mean 20 don't survive, but there's every likelihood that 80 survive. So if you don't want to get this, it means here now we are taking this 552 times 80 over 100. That will be 441,600. That is 441,600. So if you have this, this will now give you the accurate projection of that particular the particular population you are working on. Look at, we need the survival rates, because the survival rates will tell us what will be. Because if this whole number is given back to, it doesn't mean that all of them will survive, so we die. So if we know the survival rates in a particular country, you now pick the survival rate to calculate. So here, example we have here, say 80% normally survive. So from 552,000, we are now going to have 441,600 that are alive.